So if we flip the cat over, now we're looking at the anterior front side of the cat. We, of course, have the pectoralis group that's involved, among other things, in adducting the humerus, the upper arm, towards the body. It's one of its actions. We can see on the sides the serratus anterior, originating on the ribs and inserting on the scapula. It moves the scapula. In the abdomen, we of course see, running along the midline, the white line or linea alba. On both sides of the linea alba, and they haven't been really dissected to expose it, is the right and left rectus abdominis. They are running right here along both sides of the linea alba or white line. They originate on the pubic symphysis at the bottom and insert on the sternum. And of course, that's the powerful flexor of the muscle of the waist. And it's commonly referred to as the six pack, depending upon how many packs you've got, because of its segmentation or rippling effect. On the sides of the abdomen are three layers of abdominal muscles. There is the outer external abdominal oblique. Below that, the internal abdominal oblique. And below that, the transversus abdominis. The obliques obviously run at angles. And the transversus abdominis, transverse means horizontal. These muscles basically are inserting on the linea alba, along the midline. And those are all flexors of the waist. And, of course, we develop them by doing flexing activities like sit-ups or crunches. The forearm, right up here on the anterior side of the upper arm is the biceps brachii. Anterior, just like where your own biceps brachii is, originating on the scapula and inserting on the radial bone, it causes flexion of the forearm. It also, the biceps brachii, also rotates the hand laterally. That's called supination, to rotate the hand laterally. On the anterior side of the forearm, again, we use this as a landmark, an anatomic landmark. This is that brachioradialis viewed from the anterior side. Previously, we'd seen it on the posterior side. And there are four muscles that we've asked you to know on the anterior side. Right here, this short muscle, unique from all the others because it's a little muscle that ends right there, is the pronator teres. It obviously pronates the hand, rotating the hand medially, and in that respect, it's the antagonist of the biceps brachii. Right next to it is the flexor carpi radialis. Again, this is the brachioradialis that's an anatomic landmark to know where the radial bone is. That flexes on the thumb or radial side. In the middle, very characteristic, a flat silvery muscle, the palmaris longus, that flexes the palm of the hand. See it? So we pull on it. And on the medial side, the flexor carpi ulnaris. So four muscles, flexor carpi ulnaris, right in the middle, going to the palm, characteristically a flat silvery muscle, the palmaris longus, the flexor carpi radialis, and that short pronator teres. So that's the muscles of the forearm. We mentioned the biceps brachii. Up here in the on the underside of the jaw, this is the mylohyoid muscle, one of several muscles that raises the hyoid bone, pulls it up towards the mandible. So it originates on the mandible and inserts and pulls the hyoid bone. On the sides of the neck, is the sternomastoid, and lateral to that, the cleidomastoid. These are not that well dissected. So for those of you watching the video, some things are not as clear as they should be. I'm just using whatever cat they handed me. This is the sternomastoid. It originates on the sternum, inserts on the mastoid process of the temporal bone. The cleidomastoid originating on the clavicle, cleido for clavicle. And that, of course, flexes at the neck. We have those on the left side, and they also exist on the right side, but they haven't been dissected. All right.